Sharks don't have bones.
Their skeletons are made of cartilage, just like our noses and our ears.
Today, the campers go on an adventure to discover the lake monster. Cat fact, some sharks live in fresh water. Joining them are Jess Cramp, Myria Perez, and Kiki Jenkins. We dive in to learn all about sharks and our prehistoric ancestors, how to use a science notebook, and why marine sustainability is so important. Dive on in, the water's fine.
Legend has it, this land we're sitting on used to be part of a giant lake. There lived an ancient water monster, older than the dinosaurs, and bigger than a house. Nobody dared swim out too far, because if you disturbed it, it would swim until it was right under you, open its mouth filled with razor-sharp teeth, and swallow you whole.
Oh no!
And to this day, every summer, there are campers who swear that on a clear day, you can go to the lake and see the ancient sea monster that has been here for thousands of years.
There's no way.
For once, I actually agree with Malachi. They probably just saw a really big fish or something.
No, I would have recognized a big fish. It was some type of shark. It was definitely probably some big shark.
You actually saw it.
It's just a story. She's just saying that so it can seem more convincing.
I am not. And if you don't believe me, we can go down to the lake and see it for ourselves tomorrow.
Fine.
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 I'm so hungry.
It'll come out any second now. It has to. I saw it on a day just like this.
Can we go back for a second lunch? Nothing's coming out the water.
Gia? Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Kitty! Hey, Kitty.
Looks like you're having trouble finding the famous lake monster. Connecting you to my synchronized swimming teammates.
Hey guys, my name is Jess Cramp. I am a shark researcher and a marine conservationist.
Hi campers, my name is Myria Perez and I'm a paleontologist.
My name is Kiki Jenkins and I am a marine sustainability scientist.
So what do you think came first, dinosaurs or sharks?
I think maybe sharks came first. I think dinosaurs came first because then I think the dinosaur decided to grow a tail and some gills and just hop in the water. And that's probably how sharks were made.
Sharks actually existed long before the dinosaurs. The earliest records are around 450 million years old.
Whoa!
So the earliest sharks we think are from the early Devonian period, and they were very successful. In fact, there's an age called the Carboniferous period where we have the golden age of sharks, where they diversified and dominated the oceans and took on many different forms. Megalodons existed around 23 million years ago, which is after the dinosaurs went extinct. They're
huge.
I even have a tooth to show you from one. And this is a smaller tooth as well. You can see they're about the size of my palm of my hand. And they would have five rows of teeth on top and bottom jaws. And these teeth were shed constantly.
Whoa.
So I know that you are on this incredible adventure to find out what's going on. And you can do that safely from afar using your notebook. Think of a science notebook as like a daily diary of all your scientific activities. I actually have one of mine right here. Mine is waterproof because I work on the ocean. I use my science notebook every time I'm out in the field. I record not just the observations of what I see, so for example, what the tides were doing, what the swell was like, what the wind was like, but also I record my research. So when I catch a shark, I will record what type of gear I used, what type of bait was used, what size the hook was. I'll also record the species and sex of the shark and all of the measurements. So my science notebook is actually the most important part of all of my research, and it helps me to better understand how to change my experiments or my fishing methods or to use the same things if they might have worked really well.
Hey, thanks for helping us out.
A lot of people think that sharks are these really dangerous creatures who are out there waiting on the beaches to eat you. And that's not true. There are not that many shark attacks, and they don't routinely eat humans. And so we can start talking about them just like any other creature in the ocean. People will feel better towards them and want to help them. Marine sustainability is important because 70% of the world is oceans. And the creatures that live in it, the fish that live in it, help sustain people. They're a source of protein. It's a place of enjoyment, recreation, work, and livelihoods for people. We need to take care of the oceans because without the oceans, our planet can't survive.
Woohoo! Sustainability.
But one of the things that I do when I can't figure out, you know, who's down there and what's happening, I'll actually drop cameras. And that allows me to safely observe from afar, but also without disturbing anyone that might be below the water.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Drone time.
Wait. What's that over there?
What is that? That is a fat fish.
Catfish.
Interesting.
Where's Tony Shark at?
I don't think we're gonna name him Tony Shark. What about Sharkira?
Oh, that's a good one.
Okay, like sorry, one. Guys, come on. Get back to the board.
Focus.
What about that?
Oh.
Come on. What happened? It's all static.
Gia, Kiara, and Malachi, I'm so impressed. You did a great job today, following your curiosity and doing it in a way that you left the environment the way it was when you saw it.
There is so much space for you to be a scientist and help us learn more about these fascinating animals.
Well done, team. Well done.